Well, here we are again, guys. It is the end of 2020. Yes, we actually made it. I can't believe that we did. It felt like a year that was just never going to end, but we finally did make it towards the end of this year, and you know what? I figured that since last year, I didn't get to do one of these sort of like year-end videos. I mean, I might as well make up for it. And I can't think of a year that is more deserving of a reflection type video than this one. Because, wow, is there a lot to talk about. A lot of shit went down this year, obviously. But as usual, it's going to be me mainly reflecting upon how my year was, what I accomplished on this channel, and then what I plan to do in 2021. So I guess we'll just get into it. Look, it's no secret that 2020 was not an easy year in any way. And of course, it didn't start off that way. You know, things started off pretty normal. It's kind of weird looking back at it. I was just watching the anticipated video I did on my friend 22 Tiger Dude's channel back in the end of last December, and none of us knew what was about to happen. Half of the movies we talked about didn't even come out. They still haven't come out because they were delayed, and it's just crazy to look back on because, again, it's just nothing that anyone could have predicted. It was just such an unprecedented thing that ended up happening, but of course, you know, the pandemic ended up taking the bulk of this year, and it was a very devastating period. And for a while, yeah, it was very hard for me. And not to say the rest of the year very much wasn't. It was definitely very hard for me as it went on to stay motivated. You know, I didn't have, like, a job or a steady income or anything like that. I was taking classes, but they were, like, all college classes, but they were all, like, online, and it just wasn't the same as it normally was. So it was just very rough in that way. I would say around April, though, is really when the year changed for me in a very positive way. You know, I talked about this in my video, but this is where I end up venturing into the sequester world, but now more just the org world, the world of online reality games. And through doing that, you know, I got to meet a lot of amazing people. I got to connect with so many different kind of individuals from so many different walks of life. And a lot of those people have become close friends of mine. A lot of them are people that I talk to every single day. One of them ended up being my girlfriend as well. So, like, there's a lot of stuff that's gone on through that. And if there's anything that kept me grounded and kept me somewhat sane, it really is that, because that gave me something to focus on. And I've talked about this before, like, if I don't have something to look forward to, it's hard for me to stay optimistic. It's hard for me to stay positive. And so by having something to look forward to every single week, whether it was a game I was playing or, you know, a game that my friends were playing, or just something as simple as being on a Zoom call, that was something that I very much look forward to every single week. And every single day, and I never took it for granted for a second. And so that's really what got me through this year. But going on to the YouTube side of things, it gave me a lot more time to, you know, do YouTube videos. And for a while I was, but as I started to get more ingratiated within that community, I definitely did fall back on videos a bit. I didn't upload very much at all in the summer. I mean, I uploaded my 13 Reasons Why season 4 review, and then I didn't come back until, like, September, really. Like, I didn't do anything in July, nothing in August. Like, I just was not very active at all. And I'm sure I talked about this before, like, I never intended for that to happen, but it did. And, you know, on one hand, I can understand why something like that would happen, because I was so fixated on other stuff, and there was a period of time where all I focused on were just playing games and talking to these new friends and things like that than I did with movies. But I think also it was just, I needed to take more time to focus on social relationships, and that really did come first this year. You know, I think this year more than ever, what I learned was how important social relationships really are, how important social connections really are, because if you don't have that good support system, especially during hard times like this, it could really send you over the edge. And gratefully, I was able to do that. I was able to develop a good group that I could come to during hard times and things like that. And I think that's something that I'm very happy for in 2020. And because of that, like I said, I didn't focus as much on, you know, reviews and YouTube and stuff like that. But I did try to make up for that in the second half of this year. These last 4 months, like, I told myself I'm gonna get back to doing what I love. I'm gonna try to upload more consistently, and I think I did for the most part. I think I did enough. There's still definitely a lot of stuff that I need to upload, my worst list, my best list, a lot of TV show stuff. I really fell back on that, and I'm trying to get back into at least reviewing some seasons of television from 2020 before, you know, the show's premiere in 2021. I know Cobra Kai comes out tomorrow, but, like, aside from that, there isn't really a lot coming out in 2021 TV-wise, so I think that'll give me, time to do that stuff. But I'm still very happy with what ended up happening, because for a while, I wasn't really watching many movies at all, and it really got to me in August that, like, I really need to buckle down and, like, discipline myself and get myself to just, like, watch stuff again, because it was very hard for me to do that for a while. Like, again, that's how focused I, just how unfocused I was when it came to movies. Like, it wasn't really a priority of mine, and so it really, I think, came back to the forefront in September, mainly due to, like, Tenant and I'm Thinking of Ending Things. Like, those two films especially is, I think, what really helped me get my mojo back, even though I wasn't a big fan of Tenant. Like, the fact I went to the theater and actually saw it, and, you know, I was excited to review it and things like that, I think that's really what ended up doing it. And just from there, I tried to prioritize myself a little bit more, and because that, I did end up watching a good amount of movies this year. I didn't watch as many as I have, you know, but that's also because there weren't as many releases this year. There were just not as many films as there normally are, so unfortunately, I just wasn't able to watch as many, but I still was able to get to at least over 200. That's always my goal, is to get to at least over 200, and I was able to do that this year, so I'm very happy, and especially, like I said, considering that for a while, I wasn't really watching much at all, I'm honestly really proud of myself that I was able to do that. So I think that's definitely a really big accomplishment. Other things are, I was able to hit my goal of 9,000 subscribers very early on this year, and I am just so utterly grateful for that. I mean, you guys, I've talked about it for years, but, like, you guys really are just the best. I've done this for about 8 to 9 years now, and I can't believe that I'm still at it, and I can't believe that you guys are still watching. You know, your undying support just means the world to me, and it's another thing that just really keeps me going. There are days where I'm like, do I really want to do this anymore? You know, is this really worth it? Do people still care? And then I see that you do, and it means a lot to me, and I definitely have not taken a second of that for granted either, so that's something else that definitely really did help me throughout this year, and really just moving forward. I think, you know, in terms of 2021, it's all about looking forward. We don't want to look back. The pandemic's not over or anything like that, but things are starting to get better. Vaccines are, like, slowly rolling out and things like that. You know, we have a certain person now to the office that was, you know, really hurting us more than helping us, so that's always great, of course. A lot of stuff to look forward to within the new year. I don't know when we're going to get back to that period of normalcy, but I'm going to continue trying to do the things that I love, which are movie reviews and, you know, having these different collab reviews with my friends. I have one for WandaVision coming up with Film Photo 599 and Auburn Wanderer. We're probably going to do one for Falcon and Winter Soldier as well. So we have that. We have the movie previews, which are going to be the same format that they've been in. Talking to my friends, this is essentially what they've wanted. They want to keep it in this format because it's just easier for them that way, and I understand that, especially when things aren't normal. I understand why they want to just do it as I've been doing it with, like, the Google form, and then I introduce all the films, and then they come on, like, whenever. I get why they want to do it in that way, and that's perfectly fine for me, so we're going to continue to do that. And like I said, any movie or TV show reviews that I have left over from 2020, that might bleed into 2021. But like I said, I'm just really hoping that 2021 is a positive year. I think after such a tumultuous and just constant year of misery, I think what we need is just some hope moving forward. I think that's really what's important. We need that hope that things are going to get better, that there are better days ahead. And I know that this has been a really rough year for a lot of people. Some people, unfortunately, have not been fortunate enough to, you know, have that support system. Some people don't have, the things that other people do, you know, and some people, maybe that's not even enough for them. Maybe they had relatives that died or they had a friend that died. And I am so sorry if that happened, you know, if that happened to you, that's very unfortunate. It's obviously very tragic. And, you know, it's definitely something that takes a toll on you, and it could really make you think, you know, it could really make you lose sight of everything because of that. But you just need to keep telling yourself that there are better days ahead, that things are going to get better. And that's what I'm going to keep telling myself in this new year. You know, I have things that I'm very grateful for. I'm going to continue to focus on those things, hopefully get like some kind of a job or something like that, and just move forward with myself. And, you know, just tell myself that like things suck now, but like things are going to get better. And I hope that that does end up happening. Like I said, I know this year has not been the easiest for a lot of people, myself included. It has definitely not been the easiest for. There have just been some days where I've just felt so unmotivated. I've not really wanted to do anything. I've spent a lot of time for myself, but it also gave me time to do some self-reflecting. It gave me time to really just, you know, value the people that I am friends with, choose the people that I want to be friends with, you know, continue to maintain those relationships that maybe I wasn't doing as good of a job with, reconnecting with certain people. I think that's one of the things that 2020 has really given me throughout the year. And so that I am definitely very grateful for, but it does not take away from the fact that this year definitely was not the easiest. And, you know, that's really, I think, all there is left to say. Moving forward, I just hope that I'm able to, you know, continue doing what I like to do. I hope this was enough for you guys. Like I said, I know I'm kind of rambling on, but I just figured that I might as well do one of these since I did not do one last year. But that's really this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. The next time I see you guys, of course, will be in the new year. So if it is New Year's for you guys already, Happy New Year. But then if it's not, then, you know, if it's not, then I will see you guys in the new year for sure. And just very excited for what 2021 will bring us. Very optimistic for sure. But that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll see you guys in my next video, and we'll see you guys for that. Happy New Year, guys. Bye.